Good afternoon. I'm Yaron Kohlberg, president of Piano Cleveland, and welcome to second round session one of the Cleveland International Piano Competition. As you all know, we are allowing all our contestants to perform twice during the competition, and today will be the beginning of the second round. You'll hear the wonderful 26 contestants who recorded in 10 locations worldwide and of course have followed the safety guidelines in each location, meaning that some of them are masked and some are not. Tonight, you will hear performances by Lin Ye, Stefano Andreata, Ying Li, Honggi Kim, and Lucas Tomasino. Our intermission feature will be presented by Konstantin Suchowetsky, 2003 CIPC medalist and current lecturer at the Juilliard School. This afternoon's performance is generously supported by the Cleveland Orchestra. While you're watching tonight, you're of course welcome to continue to send your wonderful well wishes on our broadcast page to your favorite contestant and to contribute to our contestant fund, that all the donations are gonna go to our contestants who do not make the semifinal round here in Cleveland. Thank you very much for being with us today, and we hope you enjoy the performances.
Hi, my name is Lin Ye. I'm from Dalian, China. I look forward to sharing my second round performance with you. Now I want to share a memorable musical experience I've had. When I was 10 years old, I got an opportunity to play in the biggest concert hall in my home city, Dalian. It was my first time to be able to play on a big stage with a very good piano, and I was very excited about it. During the performance, I felt something I've never felt before. When I was playing, I somehow sensed the concert hall is responding to me, is talking to me. And I felt, I heard more colors in my piece, and I felt more emotions in that music that I practiced so many times. And it feels like my music is talking to the concert hall, and the concert hall is responding to it. And I also sensed it was a very strange feeling, but very good feeling. I somehow sensed the presence of audiences. I could feel their breathing. I could feel their excitement or the silence. Anyway, after the concert, my piano teacher back then talked to me. He said he was so shocked that he never heard me play like that. It was very good. He said breathtakingly good. And the audiences were so engaged and so impressed. He asked my parents not to force me to become an engineer, because both of them are engineers. He asked him to let me pursue piano professionally. And I did. After that concert, I knew I could become a pianist. And during my studies, I look for more opportunities to play on big stage, because I want to share that feelings, share my music to the audiences. I want the audiences to feel what I feel when I was playing. Yes, and I enjoy doing it very much. Well, that's my story. Thank you very much. Hope you enjoy my second round. Thank you. Hello, my name is Stefano Andreatta and I'm from Italy. I look forward to sharing with you my second round performance. A memorable musical experience I've had is certainly the satisfaction after maybe a good result of a competition or a really well done concert. But I have to say, the most beautiful thing is when the others' recognition click with your feeling, your strong feeling, positive feeling on stage. I found those two things not always related. The music in times of crisis is very important because it has the power to keep you alive in a certain sense, and also it elevates you in another dimension, and I think it's a way also to create your own world when the world is kind of a very bad and very desolating land.
Thank you.
my friends in Cleveland, and piano aficionados around the world. Most people know me from my work as pianist and composer, but I had a great privilege of becoming an actor in my teens back in Russia. We're storytellers as musicians. We just don't have words, but music. So we're telling abstract stories to our audience. But in order for us to express a very specific, powerful emotion, we need to have a very specific, powerful narrative behind the scenes. And that is where narrative musicianship comes in. It begins with research. We need to try to determine what is the probable meaning of the music. Now, how does this relate to me? What do I have in my life and in my life's experience that actually resonates with what the music is about? We have to create that connection, that bridge from composer's emotional experience to ours. And the more specific it is, the better, the more powerful the result. We are constructing our narrative. We have to decide who you are and where you are. Where are you coming from? The interesting thing about it, that it also enables you to use your stage fright and performance anxiety to fuel the character's emotions, right? Most of the music occurs in a dramatic setting. Something is the matter, right? Something isn't just happy and wonderful. So what we can do is we can say, yeah, I am fearful. I am anxious right now, but so is my character. How old am I? Where am I coming from? Am I hopelessly in love with somebody who doesn't reciprocate? All these things are anxiety creators, and they can have occurred to your character right before you're entering the stage. So when you come on the stage and to tell your story with the baggage of what happened right before, you're already living in that moment. Long before the music starts, the silences have extraordinary power to really generate a sense of fear, a sense of not knowing what's coming to you, not expecting anything in particular. It's just like in real life. It's reaction to situation. And we have to remember that silence is the sound. Today, you will be hearing a remarkable Fantasia in D minor by Mozart, one of my favorite pieces. And it happens to be a perfect example of narrative musicianship. Of course, the research tells us this is incomplete piece. His original manuscript just ends in bar 97. My narrative starts in the dark, and we encounter the character of the music in a really bleak, hopeless space. We know the key of D minor is meaningful to Mozart. He doesn't just use it. It's a key of Requiem, and it's a key of Don Giovanni, in which Commendatore, you know, appears, which is essentially his father figure. It is a very dramatic, powerful, dark, scary key for Mozart. Incredible Adagio is so moving. My narrative, for instance, you know, I am learning of a death of my father in it, right? So it is the finality of life that I know I can't replace. And so my character is just lost and tragically deprived of comfort, because that who comforts him is no longer around. And those presto passages are just the basically that hysterical outburst when you cannot control yourself anymore. It is that sort of, I don't know what to do with my life now moment. But then when the final D major section comes, it's a hope. That's where there is this moment of cadence chord and rests that I mentioned earlier, the drama of silence, from where I don't know I'm going to be okay, you don't know I'm going to be okay. And then when the D major comes, it is absolutely devastating. It's hopeful and beautiful and heartbreaking, because it comes against all odds. You don't expect it. And the more that contrast is created, the more one feels it, the more extremely powerful this piece is. And I just love hearing that music. I love playing that music. And I am, of course, always listening to what people are doing that differs perhaps from my narrative. And knowing that that ending is in fact not Mozart's, that some people compose their own. And as Mitsuko Ushida does, she goes back to the beginning. So she returns to the desperate place. She's not in the happy ending. Most of the music that I play does not end well. So it is incredibly rewarding for me to experience that. And I'm also happy to say that my parents are all right and fine. So my emotional recall is not related to my relationship with my father, but it is related to some other personal experiences that I can really recall that in the moment when I need to, with help of certain exercise and things, which narrative musicianship is all about. And now I hope you enjoy beautiful playing that you're hearing. Good luck to extraordinary young musicians and contestants from all over the world in Cleveland Piano Competition. And how lucky are we to have each other, to have music, and to have technology that, despite anything and everything, allows music to continue. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. My name is Ying, and I'm from China, but currently living in New York City. I look forward to sharing my second round performance with all of you. This program features Mozart's Fantasy in D minor, Debussy Image Book 1, and Liszt's transcription of Verdi's opera Rigoletto. I'm very fortunate to be part of the Cleveland competition, and I'm more than excited to still make and share music with all of you in this different environment. This past year has been a difficult time for all of us, and really what helped me going through this difficult time was actually music. Whenever I felt lonely, whenever I felt emotional, I would just sit down on the piano bench and play any music that comes to my mind. And right away, I feel like there's someone talking with me, and I can feel there's love surrounding me. Love and peace, that's what I enjoy the most from making music and playing the piano. And I hope my performance can also bring joy, peace, or love to all of you. Thank you very much, and please stay well. Bye.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Hongki Kim from South Korea. I look forward to sharing my second round performance with you. Being a part of this Cleveland International Piano Competition is like, I feel I'm still a pianist for audience in somewhere listening to my performance now. Since last year, there have been many cancellations of concerts and many musicians lose their job, and we are still struggling with this situation. Then I would like to thank Cleveland International Piano Competition giving this opportunity to share my performance in this pandemic. That's why I can say it was also one of the memorable experience in my life to record this first and second round performance in empty hall. Even though there were only two recording engineers, no audience, no clapping at all, I was getting a feeling like it's live performance, and then I could concentrate on it. Although this round is only broadcasted at the moment, I hope I can share my performance in live with you someday. Hope you will enjoy it. Thanks. Thank you. Hello everyone, my name is Lucas Tomazinho and I'm from São Paulo, Brazil. I look forward to sharing with you my second round performance. Participate in the Cleveland International Piano Competition is a unique opportunity to share music in the midst of such difficult times. Music has been important for us to keep our minds healthy and positive in times of crisis, just like the one we are going through. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.